glad you came back. We were talking about balls a little while ago and all the different ones, but now we're in another great aspect of bowling, and that's the bowling lanes, right, Mike?
Absolutely.
Now, we're standing on a spot that's safe to stand. It's not slippery.
Correct. It's not oiled.
But I understand that little foul line right there, if you go past that, you can slip on your rear end, right?
Absolutely, yep. The surface has to have oil on it to maintain the lane. It's really to protect the lane is what it is.
Now, years ago, these were wood.
Right.
And they were all glued together, smooth.
Yep.
And standing on a regular basis.
Correct.
Now, you tell me that this is no longer wood, but it sure looks like it.
It looks nice, and it looks like wood, but it is actually a composite plastic or synthetic, as we call them, synthetic lane. And it's much harder and more durable, and we don't have the maintenance on it. We don't have to sand it every year.
I remember that was a challenge.
It was a lot of work.
It was a whole shutdown and sanding them all because... And you have a different color in the middle or in the far end, but you said that's all just in the color because back when I was working on these, you had hard maple up front and down at the far end and softer wood in the middle for less expensive.
Yep.
Your balls didn't bounce and the pins didn't bounce there, so you don't have to worry about your hard grain of wood.
Right.
But it certainly looks just like the ones I was on. And, of course, you got the same little silly dots and arrows out there for those that don't look at the pins,
The targets are there still,
That's what they are.
Whether you use them or not, they're still there.
We have something here that you have made up here to use for an example of showing different things?
Absolutely. The younger children may not be able to push the ball all the way down, and we find a lot of times we have to go down the lane and get the ball for them because they didn't get it all the way down. So we developed this ramp and a few other people. We made our own. They do sell them, but the smaller 2 and 3 year old children that can't push the ball all the way down can now put it on the ramp, push it down. It might hit the bumper, and they're going to get pins, and that's what's exciting about it.
Okay, and you can illustrate, too, because you and I have the bumpers raised right here, and that's all electronically.
Yep.
You flip a switch, and they come up.
Well, when you program the name in the computer, we program that they want the bumper, and it comes up for that person.
So when it's their turn to bowl, their name comes up on the screen, and the bumpers automatically come up.
When you bowl, the bumpers come up. When I bowl, the bumpers go down, Tom.
You got a good point there, Mike.
Right. Try it. Give it a push.
Just give it a push, okay, all right. Guaranteed a strike. Now it's all automatic. Comes down, picks up the pins, sweeps the runs off, puts them back down. Meanwhile, the ball is coming back underground and coming up to us here.
That's right. So all you have to do is carry the ball from there to there and
Okay, Mike, I'm set up here, got my ball, I'm all ready to go. I'm gonna try for a spare.
Let's see it.
Do I look like I aim pretty good? Let me see. I want to go between the, I forget the pins. One and two pin, right?
Yep.
You got it right down
on this one, you will, yeah.
Okay, let's try. Oh, no, right on the head pin. Again, over the finger hold. Oh, there it goes.
Hey, a spare.
And I didn't even need the bumper. Gee, I remember something.
The bowling shoes have a special sole on the bottom that allows you to slide, and it doesn't leave the rubber marks on the approach like regular shoes do. If we wore regular shoes, it would leave a rubber film on there, and the next person would come up and stick. So we've got to have the special sole on the bottom of the shoes, otherwise we'd have some accidents.
Both shoes are that way. It's not for right-handed or left-handed bowlers, right?
Well, they make them now where either a left-handed person or a right-handed person could use the same shoes. So it's really nice.
Okay.
Yeah.
But basically, when you're out there... If you throw with your right hand, your left foot is leading.
Correct.
Get your knee bent, and you should almost be sliding up to the foul line.
Yeah, you should slide, a few feet on your last step when you're sliding.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Okay. I'd probably slide right down. Mike is really a friendly guy. He set it up for the bumpers for me, so when it comes up, it's my turn to bowl. They automatically come up. But I'm going to do the same thing he did. Not using form. I'm using the same ball, which it doesn't really fit. Well, I'm going to see if I can't better him. So let's see what we can do, guys. It's the first time I've thrown a ball in 30 years.
Oh!
He left one, I left two. But I left a split. Dang.
Sign him up for a league, that's what I say. You hit the pocket.
Think how well we could have done if we had bowling shoes.
That's right. That's right. With our own equipment.
That's our excuse, isn't it?
That's right.
Well, Mike, one of the things about bowling in Muskegon, way back when I was involved, we had state tournaments a lot. Do you have those today?
Yes, last year we hosted the men's state tournament and brought about 20,000 visitors to Muskegon.
And that's over a period of weeks, isn't it?
Right, they start in January and they typically go through April, even into May.
And a weekend tournament?
Every weekend.
And that means they have to eat in restaurants, they have to stay in motels, hotels.
Absolutely.
They drive from all over the state. I remember them because I remember when we used to do that back then, we had a change of pens for every tournament. They used different pens on the tournament than they did during the week. So we had to pull all the old pens out, put all new pens in. Still doing it? Or
they've got to have new pens now. I mean, they have to be a little break in, but they're newer pens anyways.
Okay, sure. So yep. It's a whole different ball game.
A little bit.
But now you bring, how many people come in for it? When Muskegon hosts, because it goes to all the bowling alleys, but you host the state tournament.
Well, there's several different tournaments, but like the men's or women's state tournament, they'll bring in about 12,000 bowlers and plus their families. We're 20,000 people over the course of a few months in town, so 600 to 1,000 people every weekend.
Major economic impact. So bowling, even though it's kind of a quiet sport, if you're not involved with it, you don't even realize it's there. It has a major impact on our community, doesn't it?
Absolutely. They spend money all over town.
Now, when you get these tournaments in, do you get any like top-notch name bowlers in at all?
You know, typically we have, because Brunswick's still in town, their marketing and their management team is still here in town. They bring the pros in quite often to do marketing work, and they come here to the bowling center and bowl. And actually, the Brunswick staff, their pro staff, was just here a few weeks ago and did
really?
Some promotions and did a little marketing, and they actually came out and did some giveaways to our bowlers.
Well, also, too, if they need to practice and try anything out, you're awful close to their backyard.
Absolutely.
Has it helped?
Oh, yeah. They like to come here and get a chance to try out the new equipment and some of the latest things that Brunswick sometimes tests here, so sure.
Now, that's the state tournament. You said there's other tournaments, too. What?
You know, probably the biggest growth in our bowling industry is high school bowling, and we've been fortunate enough to host the state finals for a couple of the different classes. So that's a big draw for regionals, invitationals, and the state finals have been here.
Never realized high school bowling is that big of a thing.
It continues to grow by leaps and bounds all over the country.
Okay, and then over the years, if I'm not mistaken, there's usually nonprofits that will have bowling events.
Oh, sure. You bet.
That will bring in a lot. It's a fundraiser for them, but it brings a lot of image to your bowling alley. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Groups like Junior Achievement and Big Brothers and some of the other groups that have some really nice fundraisers and bring people out. Maybe they don't, maybe only bowl once a year, but they have the opportunity to come and see what bowling's all about.
They have fun doing it?
Absolutely. Every time.
You ever seen anybody fall for bait?
I've seen a few bad ones, I've seen a few bad ones.
Well, those provide memories, right?
Well, hopefully that's all they have, yeah.
But, you know, when you're getting everybody out when you're doing some of that, and that by working with these organizations, you can increase the people that are out there bowling or never have before. So.
Absolutely. We're hitting new markets every time that we bring some new people into our business.
Well, is there anything I missed so far? I know we're going to turn on some cosmic lighting a little later, but I've tried to pick up all aspects of bowling as my limited memory will allow me to do. But, I mean, it's a big organization. Well, I tell you what, leagues. How many leagues during the week do you have?
We still have about 60 bowling leagues.
We
still have a couple thousand people that bowl every week.
Oh, my gosh. Gets them out of the house, right?
Absolutely. It's some fun with friends and family or coworkers.
Oh, that's great. But that's what it is. And,
sure.
And, of course, bowling, if I'm not mistaken, leagues go probably from, what, September to April or something?
You know, that's one of the things that's changed in our industry is leagues can be as short as 10 weeks or maybe as long as 30 weeks.
Really?
And depending on the schedule and how much time that they want to enjoy bowling.
Because I know the 30 weeks, once in a while, it can be a long commitment for a lot of people. But this 10-week, that's got to be a blessing for a lot of us.
When you live in Muskegon, you know, and the weather can be tough in the winter, you're happy to get in here out of the weather. So,
sure. The only thing you do when you walk in this kind of weather that we're having today, you got to make sure you get all water off your street shoes.
Yeah, take your wet, snowy boots off.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Because that water can affect your bowling shoes and everything else out here, right?
Correct.
Major, major issue.
Yeah, slip and falls are a concern, so we try to get everybody to take their shoes off.
Okay, well, I think we're going to check out our little cosmic bowling, and then after that, I want to ask you about some of the other stuff that you have, basically on the other side of the bowling lanes to make people happy when you're here.
So, fantastic.
We'll be back.